My name's Pete Sadler, I'm head of software at Midas. We're here at Synthfest in Sheffield showing our DeepMind 12. We're also showing a world exclusive augmented reality interface to our DeepMind 12 as well. And with that, you can see inside the DeepMind, you can look at the mob matrix, you can see the envelopes, and you can do lots of really interesting things. People have been playing it today, so let's look at some of the reactions.
I thought the immersiveness of it was fascinating, even just for the few minutes that I was using it there. I thought you felt as though you were somehow in the synthesizer, as it were. And I thought it was absolutely fascinating.
It was really nice. It's really nice just to have a hands-free experience where you've just got nothing in front of you, and no keyboard, no nothing, and you can just get really organic with it and really have a good play.
Visually, absolutely beautiful. It looks amazing. I love the fact that you're like looking around for things. If you want to find something, you've actually got to like physically look around, which is absolutely beautiful. I love that. It's a, well, I guess like anything, it's a bit hard to get used to at first, just like judging how far you have to reach and where things actually are in that virtual space. But once you've got the hang of it, it runs so smoothly and it's really nice, really nice.
I do think it's quite revolutionary, just seeing everything in front of your eyes, really, that comes out of the keyboard.
I really enjoyed that experience. I think it was quite a beautiful thing. My mind is a little bit blown still. I've just come away from something that I've been trying to grab hold of that's completely intangible. I wanted to be able to spin it around on its head and feel a little bit more substance about it. It's interesting to see where the future's going in terms of augmented reality and virtual reality, and I think that just gave me a little bit of a taste. So it's kind of given me a bit of inspiration to go away with and think about. But all in all, as a music synthesis function, I think it's got a world of possibilities, and like I say, just really enjoyed the experience. I'm really grateful to be one of the first people to have a go at that.
The R&D of the augmented reality and the way that it's being implemented here is ideal. So, for example, you had the sequencer running, and then you could like move this cube around in like a 3D space and move it around, and it changed the sound. I think that was great for a live performance. So it'd be cool to have that and have it up on the back screen so people can see what you're actually doing. And I can see, even though it's like early days, I can see how it could be expanded to something really big.
The bits that I particularly liked was being able to see. I loved seeing the envelopes, and I loved it. And then I started to sort of see how that was the way I could really see how the technology could really work, because, you know, and adjusting the envelopes there and seeing that heads-up display reacting to it. But it was really nice seeing all three envelopes at the same time, and then you could just toggle between them. I also thought it was interesting seeing the green dots on the keys for like learning keys or learning songs. I thought that was pretty cool too, to integrate that technology into real life situation. You know, I think it's going to be quite interesting, but I certainly think with a synthesizer that's as complex and as deep as the DeepMind, being able to visualize it. I like the mod matrix as well. In fact, the mod matrix was really interesting because I've been really intrigued about the mod matrix, and seeing it is actually, whoa! Actually seeing what you know, all the sources and all the destinations, I thought that was really cool as well. And, you know, that was this big, you know. How are you gonna do that on a physical synth? So yeah, so that side of things is really cool. I think as well, it's a brilliant way of exploring that synthesizer, because it's a deep synth. It's a lovely synth. I'm really quite taken with it.
One thing I really liked was looking at the keyboard and seeing like the virtual representations of where the faders were and which keys and which were in the scale. Yeah, it was really nice. It made everything simple. Everything was right there that you needed. The circular layout of the menus was great as well. I loved it.
Some of us have got used to moving from the hardware world to the software world, or moving from the physical controller to the iPad controller, or whatever, you know, the screen controller. This is just the next step beyond that, and it has its place along with every other tool in the musician's arsenal, I think.